I'm the artistic director of the Cynthia Woods Mitchell Center for the Arts. I'm joined by my co-director and the managing director of the Mitchell Center, Melissa Noble, and we are very, very pleased to welcome you to tonight's performance. I'm going to say just a few words about the program, and then I'm going to hand it off to Melissa to say a few words about the Mitchell Center, and then we're going to hand it off to the curator of tonight's evening, Donald Raven, to introduce the program itself. So, Convergence Research is a program that is co-produced by the Blaffer Museum of Art and the Mitchell Center, and it was really launched with the idea of bringing together the multitude of disciplines that live here at the College of the Arts. So we wanted to give a platform for visual art and music and theater and dance and film and architecture and design and all of those things that circulate in and around art, the opportunity to meet, converge, collaborate, and produce things that couldn't, you know, be achieved single disciplines alone. And it's just been so thrilling, honestly, to see this program grow to tonight's season finale, which we feel, I think, is the most, got the highest production value from any Convergence research thus far. So we're just so excited to see the way that this program has developed. So for all of you in the audience that may be interested in developing something in the future, we are always open to hearing ideas. Performances can be produced in any state of development. They can be ideas that you don't want to workshop, all the way to a very finished program like you're going to see this evening. So just always feel free to approach us. We're always interested in ideas. We're going to take a summer hiatus, but we'll be back in the fall with a whole new program at Convergence Research. So thank you again for being here, for supporting the artists, for supporting UH, and we just really hope that you enjoy this evening's program. I'm going to hand it off to Melissa now.
Logistics that go into this program. So we have a graduate assistant from the Arts and Leadership Program here at UH, and they are here for an entire year in the Mitchell Center. They work closely with me as my graduate assistant, and we work on this Convergence research together. But Donald has really done this year primarily on his own for the most part, and he's done a great job. I want to tell you a little bit about the mission of the Mitchell Center. That's part of why we support this program, because our goal and mission is to not only bring visiting artists to the campus, but also to support convergence and collaboration between the areas of the different schools in our college, and that is the performing arts and the literary arts. So we really try to create platforms and opportunities for students and to experience or create those things.
Exciting, and what a wonderful production. The artists have been working so hard over the course of the semester to present this final product, and I'm looking forward to it, and I hope you all as well. This evening, Polyoptic Paradox is a celebration of interdisciplinary research, experimentation, improvisation, and performance that aims to investigate the complexities of the relationship between meaning and responsibility. The performance will be split into three sections. Part one, a behind-the-scenes film functioning as an intermission, and part two. Each element will take place over the course of 15 minutes. Three dancers will each embody a character archetype represented by a shape, square, triangle, or circle, see on the stage. The square encapsulates responsibility, the triangle personifies ego, and the circle symbolizes freedom. Just a little bit about the artists. As a group, the Polyoptic Paradox team came together to deliver an interdisciplinary sculptural movement experience. The artists sought to escape the confines of compartmentalized artistry through a multimedia endeavor in collaboration with Convergence Research. They wanted to provide an experience that left the White Cube Gallery and instead creating an immersive production that combines the senses of proprioception and interoception. By mixing together elements of dance, theater, music, sculpture, painting, and videography, they optimized a new format for storytelling. The artists for this evening's performance are Julia Kidd, Alexander Lechin, Mark Fury, Monica Arenas, Daniela Romero, and Taylor Terry. Now introducing Polyoptic Paradox.
Thank you. The theme of Polyoptic Paradox centers around the ideas of freedom and responsibility, and taking that dichotomy and figuring out how to find balance.
There's a narrative that is consistent in a lot of stories that we probably hear growing up, you know, using three shapes, square, triangle, and circle, we are using them to represent different types of archetypes.
Each of the dancers is characterized by a square, a circle, and a triangle, and each of them begin in different parts of their journey between freedom and responsibility.
The triangle represents the human experience, basically us as humans trying to navigate and learn how to find balance in our lives. The square is symbolic of responsibility, rigidity, staying within the confines of what you're supposed to do. And the circle is symbolic of freedom, creativity, freeform expression, and just being fluid. And through the narrative of this project, we want to visualize the experience that we have trying to integrate both of those into our lives.
And with the dancers, seeing someone move and how they use their body, it's given me such an appreciation for what I do in the rest of my practice, seeing the body in motion.
These dancers, they're young dancers and they're so confident and open to exploration. I was just inspired by the way that they didn't really know something sometimes, but still were willing to try. And that was a really, really cool thing to watch.
I joined the Convergence research because it's my first time collaborating with other fine artists. And I think it's great to expand your artistic toolbox and finding ways of like thinking.
This process for me has been really interesting because we have experimented a lot with costumes, with a lot of visual arts. It's been a challenge, but I like it.
And with this project, we kind of have it outlined for us. There's like a storyline that is like the basis of it. And also like the music. And the music is very different than what I've ever danced to.
For the performance, actually I'm really excited to see how it comes everything together with the lights, the costumes, and we're gonna have some, like a cage, like something in the front that is gonna look amazing.
You know, new things about like the moiré expression and how there's like different illusions. I'm just like learning about that because I didn't know exactly how that worked.
The moiré illusion happens when two planes of lines that are about the same frequency overlap, and the interaction of these two planes combined with the very micro movements of our eyes creates the illusion that there's a ripple happening.
Additive and subtractive color theory is the difference in two types of primary colors. If you shine blue light on cyan ink, the cyan ink absorbs the blue light, so you can't see any of the cyan color. It disappears to the eye. But if you shine red light on cyan ink, the cyan ink absorbs the red light and it appears black to our eye.
The illusions are executed on stage by the dancers manipulating the costumes and interacting with props on stage.
I am absolutely enamored by Alex and also the dancers. I think seeing Alexandra work and her practice and her interests and how they complement mine is very interesting.
Me and my collaborator, the more that we got excited about the project, we realized that we bit off a lot more than we can chew, but in a very exciting way.
I'm a fan of curves and soft and flow, and her practice has to do a lot with straight edge line. And seeing how they can come together has been a wonderful experience.
It was challenging to stay on top of it and bring together our strengths in a way that was symbiotic. I'm very sacral and in the moment, and Julia's very good at keeping a plan and keeping us on track. Finding that balance even within ourselves and in that collaboration was a learning experience.
I was interested in convergence research initially because my practice has always been inclined towards mixed media, but I had never had the opportunity to do a large-scale interactive, immersive performance. And I wanted to take this opportunity to try to live out that dream.
What got me interested in convergence research was my interest in working with some of the other schools on campus. And it was through me poking around that I learned about convergence research and its opportunities.
And so integrating just the body and the formal qualities of paint with narration, it's definitely been done historically, like if you look at Bosch. But I thought that maybe I should pick a different avenue or a different approach to narration and maybe in through performance instead of trying to integrate everything into one painting.
I wanted to make the sculptures move in more of a real way. I previously made kinetic sculptures that required interaction of the viewer, but I wanted to evolve from that and make the sculptural movement more of an experience.
Thank you. We'll grab some chairs.
Fantastic. Let's give them another round of applause. Sarah, who's been working in behind the stage with the lights.
Archetypes and developed
And once we had our archetypes, everything from stage set to props to costume adornment had to revolve around how that character would be perceived. So I think building out from there.
It was also really fun to find those moments in ourselves too, just like, oh, this is where you need to be a little bit more structured, Alex. Oh, this is where you need to give a little